Good morning to all the children of second standard A1 and A2. How are you children? I hope you are enjoying because you have just finished your first term examination. And I hope you relaxed and you were happy during this week. Now this class, we are going to start. This is our first class in term 2. Welcome to term 2. Okay? And I hope you are ready with your books. Today is Monday and it is time for our mathematics class. And I hope all of you are ready to listen to the maths class with your textbooks. Okay? And even if you don't have or you have not brought yet the books, don't worry. Okay? You just listen to me. Just listen and then understand. And then later on when you get your books, you can follow. You can see the video and follow in your textbook. So don't worry if you don't have that textbook. To begin our class, before we start our class, shall we have a word of prayer? Come on, all of you, close your eyes and bow down our heads. Let's pray. Kind and merciful Father in heaven, we thank thee, dear Lord, for all the blessings of life. We thank thee that thou hast given us yet another term, second term. Dear Lord, thank you for all the blessings of the first term and help us to learn more about mathematics in this second term. Thank you, Lord, for all the good things that thou hast added to our lives. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, children, we are in term 2 and the first lesson that we have, you don't need to worry at all. It is almost the revision of all that we learned in first term and the first lesson. It was all about, do you remember what we learned? Yes, it was about the geometrical shapes or geometry. Also, in this lesson also, it is that same portion is repeated so that you will not forget the geometrical shapes and the spellings and the everything that I taught in geometry last term. Okay, so the lesson number 1 says it is unit 1 geometry. Geometry means all the shapes. The square, the circle, come on, tell me, square, circle, rectangle and triangle. Yes, we are going to study the same thing. We are going to revise again so that you will learn in a better way. First of all, there are beautiful keywords that are given. Two keywords are given in lesson number 1 and it is open and close. Open shapes and closed shapes. Now you must be understanding, wondering what is this open shapes and closed shape. I will explain to you. Listen carefully. Do not write anything. Listen carefully. Okay. Open. What is the meaning of open? Okay. We open our books. Open means open the books, open the door, open the window, open your eyes, close your eyes and open your eyes, open, open and close. Two main words of this lesson. And we open the door and open the door and close the door. And we open the window and we close the window. We open the bottle, open, okay? Open the bottle and we close the bottle again, okay? So open and close, these are the two words. And we open the gate and we close the gate, okay? Gate is closed, so open and close. We also open our books, yes? We open our books like this and we close our books. We open our books and we close our books. So, these are the two keywords. Okay. So, what are open shapes and closed shapes? Listen carefully. do not write anything. Listen carefully. Okay, first of all, I want to show you some shapes. Okay, they are open shapes and closed shapes. Okay, let me tell you what are the open shapes and closed. By the way, I had already told you to do one project about all the shapes that we learned. The circle, the triangle and the rectangle. And four shapes that I main shapes I gave you. Square, circle, triangle and rectangle. I had already shown you in first lesson, first term. And I had shown you, you have to make a doll. And I had shown you the doll. I hope you remember, there is a triangle here. There is circle here, eyes are circle. This is also circle. And you have to make here a square and the body and the legs you have to make rectangle and the hands also rectangle. I hope you have your this is your first term project. I had already told you in first class. So you have to take this or you can cut the shapes and stick it in your project book. Last time we did not have project book, but this time we have project book now. So you stick all the shapes, cut the shapes of circle and square and all the shapes that I had given you. Okay, all the shapes that I had given you. Please make a doll out of that, or you can make any shapes, beautiful shapes, and make a doll and stick it in your project book. Okay, now what are open shapes and closed shapes? I will tell you. Pay attention, fold your hands and pay attention. Okay, the first shape that I'm going to show is, what is this? Circle. This is a circle. Okay, and it is a closed shape. Is there any way to go inside? No, no way. There is no cut here and cut there. No, circle is there and there is no way to get inside this. So it's a circle and it is a closed shape. Okay, it is a closed shape. Now if I show you another one, here is also a circle, but it is only a half circle. It looks like a C. Okay, it looks like a C. C is a like half circle, or a little opening is there, we can get inside. This is a open shape. Okay, open shape, there is a way to get inside. So it's a open shape. Closed shape, no place to get inside, there's no way. So closed shape, and this is open shape. Open because there's a way inside here, there's a place for you to enter the circle. So it's called a open shape and this is called a closed shape. Let's see another shape. Okay, what is this? It is a square. What shape is this? It's a square. Can you spell square? Everybody together, shall we spell square? S-Q-U-A-R-E, square. Spell again. S-Q-U-A-R-E, square. And square is a closed shape. Can you get inside? No, there's no way. All four sides wall is there. We cannot get inside. So square is a closed shape. And what about this? This is also a square. This is also a square, but it is a open. See, there's an opening here. We can get inside the square. Suppose this is the room also, there's a way to get inside. So it is called a open shape. Okay, open means there's a place to go inside. It's open here. Okay, so open shape, it's a open shape. And this is a closed shape. There is no opening. So this is a closed shape. Next one. What shape is this? Closed or open? Tell me. Everybody will tell. Oh, mammoth. This is a closed shape. No, 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 no. It is an open shape. See here, there is an opening here. It is an opening. So this is an open shape. It is a rectangle and it is an open shape. Rectangle has an opening here. Small cut is there. There is a way to get inside. So it's an open shape. And if you take another one, what shape is this? This is also a rectangle. See here? It's a rectangle. And then it is not at all having any opening, no open place to get inside. So it is a closed shape. Okay, it is a closed shape because there is no way to get inside. There is no way to, there is no opening here. So it is a closed shape. Rectangle is a closed shape. Shall we spell rectangle? R-E-C. Come on, everybody together with me. R-E-C-T-A-N-G-L-E. Rectangle. Rectangle is a closed shape. And suppose another one. This is also a rectangle, but there's a opening. So open shape and this is closed shape. This is a open shape. And this is a closed shape. So this is how you know if there's a way to get inside, if there is a cut, if there is an opening, it is called an open shape. And the others are called, if it does not have any opening, it is called a closed shape. Now, all that you learned, you already know what is the meaning of open shape and closed shape. Okay. What is this? Open shape or closed shape? Yes, it is a closed shape. So, circle is a closed shape. Okay, children. Now, I am going to tell you about very important things about all the shapes. Okay? Already we have learned, but there are some children who missed the first class of first term. So, in order to revise that, we have taken this video for the geometry. So, in second term, first lesson again it is geometry, because these are the shapes you should not forget. You have to remember. You have to learn the spelling. You should know the spelling. You should know to identify all the shapes. Okay? The first shape that I had already taught you is a square, right? Square. How many corners it has? Tell me. How many corners does a, okay? This is a square. Remember, all this will come in the exam as a fill-ups and match. So, listen carefully. This is a square. Repeat after me. What is this? This is a square. How many corners it has? Shall we count corners? These are called corners, okay? These are called corners. Corner number 1, corner number 2, corner number 3, and corner number 4. So, 4 corners for a square. And 4 sides. Side 1, side 2, side 3, and side 4. 4 sides. 4 corners and it is a closed shape. There is no way to get inside, so it is a closed shape. So do you remember, will you remember, children? You have to remember that a square has 4 equal sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 equal sides. Equal means all the sides are in the same length. Same length. This side and this side is the same length. This side is equal to this side. All the 4 sides have equal length. all the four sides of a square has equal length. And it has four corners, four sides, four equal sides, and it is a closed shape. And what is the spelling of square? Tell me the spelling of a square. S-Q-U-A-R-E, square. Spell again. S-Q-U-A-R-E, square. Okay. The next shape that I am going to show you. What is this? This is a triangle. What shape is this? It is a triangle. Triangle is a beautiful shape and it is also a closed or open shape. Tell me. Closed or open? Yes, it is closed shape because there is no place to get inside. There is no place to get inside this shape. So all the four sides are closed, all three sides are closed. And in this triangle, how many sides are there? You have to remember, side 1, side 2, side 3. So three sides in a triangle. How many corners are there in a triangle? 1, 2 and 3. Three corners. So triangle has three corners and three sides. Shall we count again? Corner number 1, 2, 3. Three corners, three sides. 1, 2 and 3. There is a nice thing to learn about a triangle. Okay? In triangle, you have to remember that sometimes the all three sides will be equal or they can be equal. But many other triangles also have three sides but they are not equal. For example, see here, this a triangle can have one side long, one side short. Okay, this is little shorter than this, see. So sometimes the bottom line will be very small. So all three sides are not equal in a triangle. Okay, you have to remember that. In a square all four sides are equal, but in a triangle the sides can be in different length. It may not be same. So this may be long and this may be short and this may be very long. So in a triangle all three sides may not be equal. Okay, it can be equal, it cannot be equal. But here you see that all three sides are equal. So what you will remember about the triangle? Triangle has three sides, three corners, and it is a closed shape, and also it may have all three sides equal, may not have three sides equal. That you have to remember, children. Okay, the next we are going to learn is what is this? Tell me everybody, what shape is this? Say loudly. Yes, you are right, it is a rectangle. What shape is this? It is a rectangle. And rectangle also has four sides, four corners. Okay, and it is also a closed shape. See here, corner number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Four corners. Okay, and it has four sides, side 1, side 2, side 3 and side 4. So four corners, four sides, but all four sides are not equal. See, this is one side very long, opposite to that also very long, and so opposite sides are equal. This side is short and this side also short, so opposites are equal. They are two opposite sides. Okay, one and this one and this one is same in length, and this length and this length is same. Okay, so opposite sides in a rectangle in rectangle, in a rectangle, opposite sides are equal. These are opposite. Here and this one and this one. So in a rectangle, four sides, four corners, and opposite sides are not equal. Opposite sides are equal, and all four sides are not equal. So you have to remember, children. Take some paper, draw some shapes, and try to name them. Try to spell them. And what you should do is, you should do all the exercise that are given in your textbook. When you get the textbook, do all the exercise properly. Okay? And these are the things I may give you as a spelling, or as missing letters, or as fill-ups. Okay? Page number 3, it is given. We write C for closed shape and O for open shape. Page number 3, just listen, now don't worry. Okay? C for closed shape and O for open shape. The first one is square. Square is a closed shape. So write C. Don't write anything. I will write all the answers and send you in the WhatsApp. So do not worry. Page number 3. And also there are so many given. 8 figures are given. 8 shapes are given. And you have to identify whether it is open or whether it is closed. If it is open shape, write O. And if it is closed shape, write C. Okay? And then again on the same page, it is written, draw some shapes. Draw some open shapes and draw some closed shapes. That also I will send you in WhatsApp. Okay? Page number 3. Complete the table. They will give a square. You have to write how many corners it has, how many sides it has, and you have to write the name, that means the spelling. Okay? And likewise, you have to do page number 3, square, rectangle, triangle, and circle. So that I will send. You don't do anything now. Okay. And on page number 4, lot of shapes in geo board. Geo board means that black dots are given. See here in the book, I'll show you. Black dots are given in the textbook. You just listen now. You don't need to write anything. First you listen. Page number 4. It is called geo board. This is called a geo board. Dark with all the dots. And all the see here. So in this first geo board, square is given. And you have to, in this you have to draw as many squares as small and big squares. So many squares. And in this, it's a rectangle. Okay, rectangle, there you can draw so small or big 2-3 rectangles. You have to draw in this place. Here it's a triangle. So triangle also you have to draw small or big, small 2-3 or 4, even 4 triangles you can make, or you can draw only 2 triangles. So this is how it is given in your textbook to draw some shapes in the geo board. Okay? Observe the shape in the geo board. That means identify the shape, and according to that shape only you have to draw in the dots. Okay? And then page number 5, join the dotted lines and draw horizontal. Horizontal means straight line, like this line. Okay? Horizontal line, like this line. Horizontal. Vertical means like this line, straight line. This is called vertical line. If you draw a straight line like this, it is vertical. And if you draw a sleeping line, that is called horizontal. And slanting means this. See here, the slanting line means like this. It cannot be straight. It cannot be like this. It will be like this. Crooked, little bit crooked. So this is a, see, this shape has a slanting line. This is a horizontal line. This is a slanting line. And for this, no, for this. See, like this, if you hold, this standing line is called as vertical line. The sleeping line is called as horizontal line. And curved line. Curved line means you will have in the circle, this is called a curved line. See here, it is not straight, neither it is like this, it is not horizontal, it is not vertical, it is curved. Curved means it has a curved shape. So, children, this is how we learn the shapes and the sides and the corners and all that is about the shapes in geometry lesson number 1. Okay, mathematics, unit 1, geometry. Geometry means shapes. And my dear children, I hope you will understand. I hope you know all the spellings. I hope you are learning and repeating the spellings. I know that you know how to draw the shapes. So, wait for me to give you all the information in the WhatsApp, how to write in the textbook and how to write in your new term note, second term note. So, this is the end of this for today's class. We will continue page number 6, 7, 8. We will continue afterwards. And page number 6, 7, 8 and 9, we will do it in the next class or in the Zoom class. Till then, take care of yourself. Learn the spellings. Be ready to answer when I'm asking. And all the best, children. Goodbye. Take care.